I'm going to document my solo experience on board the Valiant Lady. I have no idea what to expect. I don't know there's going to be any solo meetings. I do know that some of the solos from a Facebook group have arranged to meet at 4:30 at the bar on the Rooks, and that coincides with the muster drill. So I'm not sure that's going to work, unfortunately. And I'm really not sure what to expect. But what I am expecting is a very different experience. Now, looking at the activity sheet, there doesn't appear to be any solo meetup. Looks like there's a Friends of BLW meetup. There's obviously the assembly drill, but no solo meet. We're only on the ship for 3 days, so that's pretty disappointing. So I don't think they're doing any solo meets. Right, I did say I'll document how it's going. I did go to the Rocks. Unfortunately, I didn't see any other solos there. It was really busy and it's really difficult to know who's actually solo. There's quite a lot of large groups of people there as well. I tell you what, this is a young crowd, but I did bump into Kate and we did say that we were both meet up tonight and we're eating the Mexican because I've got the Mexican booked. She hasn't booked anything and she needs to get something booked. So we're going to meet up tonight and have company for dinner, which is wonderful. But to be honest with you, I'm really not sure how other solos are going to meet up on here. It's a case of bumping into each other. That's just a real shame. I wish that Virgin would make the effort and have a solo meetup. It makes such a difference. Just had my first dinner in the Mexican and I have my wonderful dinner guest, who's Kate. Now, unfortunately, the way it goes is we met, didn't we, at the station.
We did.
And we shared a taxi.
We did.
Because that's the only way we got to meet.
Exactly, and then we met in the bar later.
And that way we're able to have dinner together.
Yes.
Yeah, which is a...
That was lovely.
As you can see, tonight I am dining alone because my dining partner, Kate, is trying another restaurant, but she will be dining with me tomorrow night, which is great, at the Korean barbecue, which I'm really looking forward to. But I haven't met any other solos apart from Kate and Susan on the cruise, so it's just me.
How's it going?
Now, I was about to make a video showing that I'm by myself again and I bumped into a friend of mine just from
Hello!
America. Can you believe it? Yeah? Okay, it's time to talk about my solo experience with Virgin Voyages. So how has it gone? First of all, Virgin Voyages, they make the effort to have around about 40 solo cabins of different types, which is fantastic. That means we get to sell at a reasonable solo price. But what doesn't make any sense? They don't have a solo meeting. I don't get it. Why make the effort to have solo cabins, and a lot of cruise ships don't bother, and don't make the effort to have a solo meeting? Now, the reason you need a solo meeting is that if you want to have company when you eat, and you want to have some company and be social when you go out at night, you get to meet like-minded solo cruisers. Now, there's around about 40 to 60 solo cruisers on the ship, all walking around trying to find each other, and they're not gonna do that. And many of them are probably first-time cruisers and they're probably never gonna come back. So honestly, Virgin Voyages, you really need to make the effort to have a solo meetup. Now, I have met a few people on the ship purely by luck. And it is by luck. First of all, I met Kate at Portsmouth Station. We shared a taxi and she's cruising solo. She won her cruise in a competition and she's been my dining partner for the first day and also tonight. But yesterday I dined alone because I didn't really know anybody else. I also bumped into Susan and Joe, who are part of our Cruises for Solo community, which is wonderful. So got to have another little chat with them, which is great. And to my shock last night, I sat in one of the bars and I was there by myself, again, making a video saying, where is everybody? And there was Justin, a friend of mine, who's the life and soul of the party, by the way. I met him cruising solo on the Norwegian Encore inaugural cruise. And I had no idea he was on the ship. If I hadn't bumped into him, I would never have known. Can you believe it, yeah? And not only that, I've just realised I've seen a post from the Solo Traveller, who is an Instagram blogger who posts about solo travelling, and he is on this ship. I've never met him. I didn't know he was here. Now, if they had a solo meetup, it would give the solo people, the community, an opportunity, if they wished, to be social and meet other solos. And if you do that, you end up normally making loads of friends and having a wonderful time. Now, I'm good. I mean, I talk to anybody, yeah? But I've spent a bit too much time, if you ask me, on this cruise by myself. Because you tend to sort of be watching other people having a great time. And if you're okay doing that by yourself, that's great. But if you want to have the option of meeting friends and having company for dinner and having company when you go out, Virgin Voyages, what you've got really wrong, in my opinion, and there's loads of solo travellers out there that want to cruise, is that you don't do the solo meetup. If you organise a solo meetup on day one or day two, then I promise you, it will give the solos a great opportunity to become, to make friends, to meet people, and become a little community, and they will have a wonderful time. Because when we get together, quite often, we tend to be the party people of the ship, even with Virgin Voyages. So all I would say is, I've had a wonderful time on the cruise. I'm easily pleased. You know, if a ship floats, if there's somewhere to sleep, somewhere to eat, somewhere to drink, and some entertainment, I'm happy. But I would just say, Virgin Voyages, please rethink your idea of not having a solo meetup. It would make all of the difference to the experience of solo cruisers. And I honestly think a lot more will come back if you organise a solo meetup. So that is that's basically my experience of cruising solo on the Virgin Voyages Valiant Lady. I cannot believe I've bumped into the solo traveller, Fraser, yeah?
Yep.
Now, I was thinking, why don't they have a solo meeting?
Oh, we need it.
There are so many solo travellers on this cruise, aren't there?
Yeah.
And if they had a solo meeting, then we would have had the time of our lives.
Agreed.
So Virgin Voyages, get a solo meeting going, yeah?
Yeah.